I have two scooters, PJ and A-bar. We're putting A-bar back together again and hit something of a black hole with the kickstart. No matter how I locate the pedal, the teeth in the piston always end up protruding about 3 mil above the rim. It's generally pretty slack at the stop, followed by 40 mil of very loose travel before anything happens, and then it's pretty lackluster the rest of the way. This is how it's been since day one. From a cold start, 5 or 6 kicks, sometimes more, okay after. Always started, but the feel through the pedal never inspired confidence. I couldn't figure it, so I decided to do some comparisons. I've done a fair bit of filming at various times and stages on this. Now I've got a myriad of clips. I don't want to redo them, so the following video will be an amalgam of the clips, and hopefully not a kaleidoscope. The first part will be generic to both scooters, and then I'll treat each cover individually and try and work out the best scenarios. Trying to put the scooter back together again, and I'm back in the black hole with this kickstarts. Unless you've got a totally original scooter, good reason to own more than two, you're going to have a jumble of parts to some degree, as I'm finding out. It's having a hard time trying to put the kickstart back into A-bar, so as both covers were off, I thought I'd strip them apart and compare them. I'll quote page 54, Stickies. Identify the shaft. Early Li weak type measures 67.5. Later thick shaft measures 65. The measurement was from here to here, and both these shafts measure 65. So it appears I have two late model shafts fitted to my early model scooters. This explains a couple of things. The difference between early and late is the thickness of this section here. It measures 4 mil on the late model and 2 mil on the early. 2 mil on the thickness means 2 mil deeper into the crankcase and 2 mil closer to the clutch and the cogs. Hence the need for all this butchery. And also the reason why this rim has been rubbing on the cogs. Working in two kickstarts at the same time, I was finding so many anomalies. I felt I had to locate the position of the shaft internally. I stuck a pencil down and got a mark on the bottom edge of this area, just about here. I've added 5 mil on for the skip, then done a few dimension checks. I think I've got it to within about a mil. Marked the reference pin location and the stop location. Reference pin, stop. Knowing this position helps. I cut the nib off this shaft. GP shafts come with it already removed. I thought it was fouling on the edge. I'm not sure that it was, but looking at it in this position, that's the centre, it might have been okay. It was probably designed to run round the edge of the clutch. There's a reason for everything. So you can double check that before you bother. From here to here is wasted travel, by the way. The piston does not start rising upwards till the reference pin starts travelling up the ramp. That is why this is the optimum position on the edge of the ramp. I've worked out a rule of thumb that 10 to 12 mil of travel on the kickstart equals 2 mil of upward movement on the ramp, or basically 5 or 6 mil of travel equals 1 mil of movement. I've lifted some dimensions and in an attempt to achieve some accuracy, I've used a set square with markings to 32 seconds of an inch and then converted them. And then converted them into metric. I've lifted some dimensions. Rim of the case cover to the top of the shaft, PJ 38mm, A-bar 33mm. The rim of the chain case to the top of the cogs below the clutch, PJ 37mm, A-bar 37mm. Clearance from PJ to the cogs is plus 1 and A-bar is 4. No clearance on PJ. We'll start with PJ. I'll go over as it was and how I'm going to put it back together again. Best case scenarios. I put the old shaft onto A-bar. The old shaft was a GP shaft, 65mm long. To get it to work, I had to create a concave washer to let the circlip sit in place. With the old shaft in place, the measurement from the top of the shaft to the rim was 38mm. The measurement from the rim to the cogs is 37, plus 1mm. It was fitted with a 0.5 gasket, so plus 0.5. So it's 5mm onto the cogs, hence the reason for these marks. It's been rubbing away 0.5mm. If I leave it as is, though, to overcome the issue would require a 1.5 gasket. The teeth were sitting approximately 1.5 below the top of the rim, so that would mean upward piston travel 1.5 to reach the top of the rim, 1.5 to accommodate the gasket, 2mm to mesh with the cogs, 5mm of upward travel on the piston, 30mm of travel on the kickstart. I bought a new shaft, 66.5 long. With the new shaft, I got a 1.25 flat shim and the circlip on. This is also 2mm lower in height. The teeth are protruding slightly above the rim. The height from the teeth to the rim is now 35.4. I have 1.6 of clearance between the teeth and the cogs. If I add a 0.5 gasket, I have 2.1mm of clearance between the teeth and the cogs. Add the 2mm to mesh with the cogs, 4.1mm of upward travel for the piston, 24mm of travel for the pedal. It's a best case scenario. If I put 2mm of packing here to represent the 1.6 clearance and the 0.5 gasket. This is still a GP shaft. I've taken quite a lot off here and I took this nib away as well, probably unnecessary. And this is the reference pin location. I press down hard to try and keep it straight. I have 0.5 of clearance. If you were to bend down and look horizontally along the line of the feeler gauge, you will see the daylight. I put the cover on. I put 1mm packers into simulate a gasket. Put the cover on just tight, just enough to hold the packers in place. Really like these, by the way. So easy. Start is hitting the stop. So and 30 mil of travel, best case scenario. Hey bar, as mentioned, I've never been happy with the kickstart. With engine back out, I decided to have a good look at it. Couldn't find the issue and went down the comparison route. My general understanding improved, but I still couldn't figure what the issue was. No matter how I put it together, the teeth always protruded at least 3 mm above the top of the shaft. I couldn't get the pin to locate, or the kickstart to properly locate either. Just couldn't figure it, couldn't get it to work. Considered it might be the splines and ordered a new shaft. It's a GP shaft. The rider said it measures 66.5, which it does, closer in length to an early model shaft than a GP shaft. It did not provide the answer, it did provide the clue. As I look at this, the issue is staring me in the face. I just couldn't see it at the time. When I put the new shaft into PJ, I could get a flat 1 mm shim plus the circlip on. When I put it into A-bar, I could get 3 mm of shimming on plus the circlip. And then I twigged. If you look at ads for the later model shafts, there's usually a rider stating that they can be used on early models with a modification to the crankcase. The only description I can find of the modification required accompanies a tool you can buy to carry out the modification. It's a shaft, fits in here, appears to have two small grinding stones sticking out at right angles. It then tapers to a shank you can fit in a drill. It seems you insert it in there and let it burl till you've grind, till you've ground 2 mm off this area. A-bar's had the modification done. These castellations, if they show up, are the remnants of the buttresses round the side. They're 2 mm deep. At this point, Jesus wept. I made another false assumption and assumed the shaft was a fixed object. Took my measurements from it to the rim. It's not the fixed object. It's been lowered 2 mm. The fixed object is the ramp, and it's holding the piston in its original position. I've now measured from the top of the teeth to the top of the rim, 37 mm, the same as the rim to the cogs. The teeth are touching the cogs. A 0.5 gasket will give me 0.5 clearance. Best case scenario now, 0.5 of travel for the gasket, 2 mm of travel for the teeth to mesh with the cogs, a total of 2.5 mm of upward travel, or 15 mm of pedal travel. I've also surmised wrongly that when the teeth mesh with the cogs, there would be instant turnover. Doesn't seem to be the case. The turnover is just much the same as PJ, 25 to 30 mil. I can't see any reason for it on the surface, so I guess the bite I'm looking for is somewhere deeper inside. I put the A-bar cover on, hand tight, just enough to grip 1 mm packer, which represents the gasket. I have 25 mm of travel. Good improvement in 40. And it feels really locked and loaded. This is taking a lot longer than I expected it to take. So I think I'm going to have an interlude and pause for some quiet reflection with some of the sounds that have been accompanying me through this.
Where do we go now? Where do we go?
Where do we go?
Where do we go?
Oh, where do we go now? Where do we go?
Twigged.
The next 5 minutes with some short clips. They may be of interest, they may not. I placed dividers of sorts between them.
If you can have a jumble of parts, it appears parts can also be a jumble. I now have three shafts. I put the old shaft from PJ onto A bar. If I was to line up the slots and compare it with the new shaft, it stands 2 mil taller, a bit like the one on the left. And it's 2 mil shorter at the base. I've put it onto Aber because it encases the piston a little bit higher up. And also being 2 mil shorter with a minimum grind, it's passing full size bolt heads at the base. With the new shaft I had to grind it almost to the circlip. And I still had to grind something off the bolt head. I've got a 1.25 shim on and the circlip. My original mentor on this area was Peter at Piston Ported. He's worth a look. He makes it sound so simple. Put the shaft in, hold it up tight, and it seems to be spinning freely. It's a new GP shaft, so it seems the modifications worked. I don't have to take anything from this face, which would be good, except I'm going to use the old shaft, which has already had the work done, unless I use this one and add 3 mil of shimming. I'm going to fit 1 mil cork gaskets. I'll lay them flat on clean cardboard. Smear both sides with grease and lift them into place. Gasket sealant is a pain to remove. Grease often gets a mention for this purpose. There's no pressure inside the case, just whipped oil. It only needs to be kept inside. Put the shaft on without the oil seal. Not a great idea. Took it off, put the oil seal in, pushed the shaft up from underneath. Inside here there's a small O-ring, and I pushed the shaft up from underneath, pushed in this area, pulled the O-ring out and distorted everything. Putting the oil seal on PJ, and it can be quite tricky. This is the O-ring that locates inside the inner rim. And when you're messing about, it has a tendency to come out. Because these are quite a snug fit. Take a little bit of work to get on, but the first attempt didn't work, so I'm going for a second attempt. The oil seal, very tight fit. Got them on with grease twisting motion. Still had to finish one of them off with a screwdriver. Should have remembered to try boiling water. I put the kickstarter on, moved an amp back almost its full distance in the slots. It's in the optimum position. Put the kickstarter on, 1 mil packers to simulate a gasket. It's kind of finger tight. Hasn't quite worked as expected. 3 mil of play between the kickstarter and the stop. So I'm going to take it back off. I move the ramp fully back in the slots see what I get from that. So I've moved the ramp fully back in this direction. The reference pin is bang on the edge of the optimum position. The height of the teeth hasn't altered. And the kickstart is now touching the stop. So I'll put it back together again and see what happens. So I'll put it back on just tight enough to grip the 1mm hackers. The pedal is bumping against the stop. So the best case scenario is 25mm of travel. I think quantum physics is coming into play here, as the mechanics. And then when I reviewed the videos, I heard that the crows had been laughing from above. Or was it Jesus?